This video is about how to make a fully functional cyclone separator from a bucket and two plastic elbow fittings. If you use a small vacuum cleaner in your workshop or for your home improvement projects, you will have to frequently interrupt your work to empty its dust container. With the cyclone separator addition, you can forget about your VAX dust container and filter for years. I've been using this vacuum separator setup for 4 years now and couldn't be happier. In 2 minutes, you will see that this video's title is not an exaggeration. You can make a cyclone separator literally as you cook some popcorn for watching my other videos. I also added a mobile cart to my dust collection setup. It only took me a half hour to make it. If you use your cyclone setup with a table saw, router table, planer, or other sharp machinery, you don't really need the cart. You can easily fit a bucket, two short hoses, and a vacuum under most sharp machines. Adding such simple setups to a couple of sharp machines at once can be an easy budget alternative to buying and installing a central dust collection system. I noticed a significant decrease in dust production while using it with my table saw. It's quite convenient to plug both the device and machinery into a power strip since its on-off switch can control them simultaneously. I used to hesitate on using my router table given the amount of dust it produced. Since installing the cyclone setup on it, the amount of dust has been minimal, and now I use it a lot more, such as for making my frame bow. In this footage, you can see how the wooden chips get sucked into the bucket and can't escape it. Only a small amount of fine dust manages to make it to the vacuum's filter. The main idea of a cyclone separator is to force sucked in chips and dust to its bottom, preventing it from getting to the outlet port and into the vacuum. The larger particles have difficulty following the high-speed spiral motion of the air and the vortex. They hit the inside walls of the container and drop down to its bottom. As you can see, the work principle of a cyclone separator is very simple. We are all used to conical shaped separators, but cylindrical separators work quite well too. The biggest advantage of the cylindrical design is its simplicity and compactness. The whole cyclone mechanism is fitted onto a bucket lid, which allows you to quickly replace a full bucket with an empty one by simply transferring the lid. You don't have to frequently interrupt your work and can later get rid of the full buckets by composting or burning the chips. For a jointer or planer, I recommend using larger diameter plastic fittings and hoses on the separator. Okay, let's move on to the making segment. I drilled two holes with a hole saw drill bit, one in the center of the lid, an outlet, and one right next to the edge, an inlet. I filed them slightly to snugly fit two 40mm inch and a half elbow fittings. Then I inserted both fittings into the openings and connected the hoses. I didn't even have to use a sealant. That's all there is to it. It literally took me 2 minutes to make a fully functional cyclone separator. Next, I made a T-shaped mobile cart for personal convenience. I did a quick layout job using the very vacuum and the bucket that will ride on it later. A warped piece of plywood could be made into the mobile cart. Please don't judge my temporary table saw. I also made it from wasted materials. A piece of square aluminum profile and two clamps are used as a fence on my improvised table saw. Once the plywood is cut and sanded, it doesn't look quite as bad. Using narrow leftover pieces, I made the cart's rails, mostly to even the warped base out and to make it stiffer. While doing the layout, I determined a comfortable handle height. Now we just need to assemble all four parts together using screws. It is a good idea to drill pilot holes. I didn't use glue to make my mobile cart collapsible for easy transportation and storage. Once finished with the base's rails, I cut the hose holes and handle opening out using the same drill bit that I used for the bucket lid. Then I use the jigsaw and sandpaper to round over the handle's corners and edges. Finally, I screwed it to the structure and added wheels to the cart. I used my new cart as is for almost a year and then decided to make it look nice and spray painted it. In this video, I used wooden chips for demonstration purposes. But if you use my setup on a router table, most of the fine dust ends up in the separator bucket as well. The vacuum's dust container fills up very slowly. If you need to clean up a large amount of construction trash or even a water flood, all you have to do is to find a bucket with a lid, buy two plastic fittings, and drill two holes in the lid. It's quick, cheap, and efficient. If you liked this video, perhaps you could share it with your friends. Let good people watch good videos. This is Maxi Gorov, St. Petersburg, Russia. And a final note, I only produce one or two videos max a month. And if you don't want to miss new content like this, you can click on the bell reminder for notifications. I hope to see you back on Advoca Makes.